I don't remember this loading screen. Of course, maybe I do. Hello? Connecting to server. Holy shit. Okay. Apparently, I unlocked something for my Typhoon Mark 1B. And holy shit! Welcome the achievements! Out of absolutely nowhere comes 3 million achievements. British collection, German collection, US collection, Japanese collection. And that's it. Okay. Let's flip back over here to the United States of America. Let me. Oh, these are my inactive items, eh? Okay, so that's new. All right, hello everybody, and welcome to War Thunder 1.53. It has been a long wait, 4 months, I believe, since the last major patch, and I'm ready. This is the first time popping in. I almost murdered an innocent blade of grass because it popped up saying disk write error. Would you like to retry? And it did it, and it said downloading information. I'm like, is it gonna restart the whole thing? Because see. With this new internet, I download pretty fast, okay? But not with really War Thunder because it's based off of War Thunder servers, and War Thunder servers have never really been that good, let's be honest. So it took quite a while still, it took a few hours, but I'm finally in, and I thought I had to restart the whole thing. But no, I don't. Let's turn that error on. So to go over some of the basic features of this, there are now Steam integrated achievements. If you have missed my previous video, this is part two of the overview. Part one was looking at the Steam achievements. I'm super excited for that. I love achievements in games, and pretty much every other Gaijin game has achievements or game that they're associated with, like Star Conflict, although they didn't fully develop that one themselves. Excuse me. And I always wish that War Thunder had Steam integrated achievements, and now they do. So if you'd like to hear my opinion fully on that, you can watch part one. Excuse me. Holy crap. And it's been processing this whole damn time. Like, holy crap, I think something's bugged out. I might have to re-upload it. I don't know. But it hasn't uploaded or published itself yet. There are two new maps added to the game, Across the Rhine and Stalingrad. Stalingrad Factory, both for ground forces, which both include a very special feature that we will be talking about. There are new vehicles, of course, and also let's not forget the one of the biggest additions in 1.53 is the Dagger 4.0 engine, which introduces better water and physically based rendering, and a destructible environment, which we were originally told was for Berlin only off the start, but it is not. It will be taking place on Berlin, Across the Rhine, and the Stalingrad Factory, so both the two maps in the games have destructible environment now. You can already see the physically based rendering working on the screen now. It's going to take a little bit for my eyes to fully adjust, but you can see the different lighting here. The lighting with the vehicle is a lot different. It looks a lot more realistic. It looks like real metal now instead of the same basic shading, if you will, that we used to get before. I mean, see that? We never had that kind of stuff. See that brightness, and then when you turn here, it's not? We never really had that before. So that's a really nice addition. Now, I think I can already see some changes here to the hangar's screen. It feels like it. Like, I don't remember these. Were these flags always here between? I knew there was flags back there in the actual hangar, but were these flags here, and were the flags always over there? Like, let's flip to the Germans. Yeah, see, I don't remember those flags on, like, the watchtower thing or up here. And the flags also look a little different, too. They look a little more realistic. Yeah, I think there's been some changes made in those areas. Of course, there are new vehicles throughout all of the nations. So let's go ahead and take a look. Now, this is my first time getting in, so I haven't looked at any of the. I mean, I know what some of the new vehicles are, obviously from the development blog posts, but I'm super excited to see what is actually fully new in War Thunder. So I'm going to quickly flip to aviation without looking at the tech trees there as best I can. Let's take a look at what we have on the list. Holy shit, I'm already like sperming all over the place. Okay, for starters, it looks like a change has come to the actual tech trees. We've got a line splitting the standard from premiums. I guess it's to help tell the difference between a premium and a standard because I guess people get mixed up maybe. I don't know, but that's a nice little addition there to help. Now the first additions are in tier 4 with the new P-38s. And as you'll see here, we've got the P-38J and the P-38L. I'm sorry, what? Okay, yeah, there's a P-38. Well, we're. Hello? Hello? Okay, something that I want to go over is Gaijin are, they don't show off all of their units, okay? There's not always, like, every unit they add to the game isn't always going to be on the development blog, which we can already see in works now. We never heard news of the J or L variations of the P-38. Never. The only P-38s we heard of were the P-38E and P-38K, and I don't see the K anywhere on this list. Somebody told me the K is supposed to be a premium version of the P-38, but I don't see it anywhere here. No, it must be an exclusive, or just they decided they weren't ready to add it yet. But starting off at Tier 2, we have the P-38E Lightning, which is a Tier 2 battle rating 3.3 P-38 for 11,000 RP. Let's see here. Let's take a look at this thing. Oh, look at that. Oh, this lighting looks beautiful as poop, and poop in a good way, too. Alright, so similar to the other P-38 at its rank, it carries one single 20mm A. NM2 cannon with 150 rounds and four 12.7mm M2 Browning machine guns with 2,000 rounds, and they're all based there in the nose, as you can see. So that's a nice addition. I know there are a lot of Lightning pilots in this game. One thing I do want to check out is the P-38G. Whoops. Let's check this thing out because I saw that the new lighting on this thing looked absolutely amazing. Can we. Ah! Oh, okay. Just hold on. I need a moment. I need a moment. Okay, now I might need to change my pants because that may or may not have been some sort of orgasm there. I'm not exactly sure. But holy shit, look at that. There's no way. That is amazing. Look at that lighting. Look at that lighting. It looks amazing. Holy crap. It looks like a real, like, it looks real. That's the thing. And War Thunder already looked real in the first place, and now look at it. Okay, just breathe. Just breathe. Okay. But two vehicles here that I was completely unaware of were. Now let's just check here to make sure that we're not missing anything. Any P-38s? No. Any P. No. P-63s? No. We've got two new Tier 4 P-38s. P-38s that I never ever heard of and we never saw in the dev blog, including the P-38J, which costs 50,000 RP. Okay, it also looks really badass. So the P-38J, what is different here? It carries the same exact armament as the previous P-38s, same type of 20mm cannon, same amount of rounds, same 450 cals on the nose. Battle rating 4.7, however. Let's see what might be different here. It's got 21.5 seconds of base turning time compared to, say. Okay, it's hard to tell the differences here. I'm not exactly sure what they are, but I'm not looking too much into detail just yet. And also on the list is the P-38L Lightning, which is also a 50,000 RP requirement, 4.7 battle rating vehicle. Let's take a look at this. Okay, now this is by far, in my opinion, the best looking P-38 in the game besides the P-38G that can have the invasion stripes. I love this black. Like, look at these black lines here on the wings. That looks amazing. Carrying the same exact armament. I'm not exactly sure what else is different here. Maybe one can carry bombs. I don't exactly know, but I'm sure there's some big differences here. In fact, the engines actually look different. Wait, the engines do look different, don't they? Look at those engines. Let's check the XP-38. Yeah, the engines are ever so slightly different. So there's a difference in there. Okay. No new jets. No new jets for the United States altogether. I don't think there's any new fighters in here. Any F2A or F4Us, I mean, no. Any Kingfishers, no. But there is a new naval bomber, guys. Last patch we got the FB or the SB2C-1C Helldiver, and now we get the SB2C-4 Helldiver. Required 26,000 RP, which is perfectly fine. I love that color. That is a perfect color. This thing, guys, is the exact aircraft that sank the Yamato Super Battleship or the Yamato class Super Battleship. Which, as we know, was the world's biggest battleship. It was part of the Japanese Navy, and sadly, it sank due to, I believe, a squadron of these things. So let's take a look at this. It's got, like the previous one, it's got two 20mm AN/M2 cannons, wing-based. You can see one right there and one right here. They're really tiny. It's also got a, they got 400 rounds, 200 per. It's also got a tiny 7.62mm Browning machine gun in the turret. It is a dual machine gun. And it also comes default with two A&M 57 250-pound bombs, which are obviously down there in the bomb bay. Can this thing, what can this thing equip in terms of bombs? Holy shit. Okay, this thing is pretty beefed up in terms of what it can carry once you unlock some other stuff. It can carry two 250-pound bombs, a 2,216-pound torpedo, another 2,216-pound torpedo, obviously differences there, two 500-pound bombs, four 500-pound bombs, a single 1,000-pound bomb. You can carry 1,000 and two 500-pound bombs, or eight 127-millimeter rockets. So this thing is really beefed up. I'm going to enjoy myself this thing. But that's not it for the United States tech tree. It seems the only other addition is in the actual bomber tech tree, a Tier 1 aircraft, the TBD-1 Devastator. At battle rating 1.7, this thing is only 4,000 RP in requirement, and was also one of the aircraft that was on my 45 units I'd like to see in War Thunder. Look at that lighting, guys. Oh my god, there's no way. Look, if you look closely, look into the actual metal, like, aluminum piece of the aircraft. See how the reflection of the wings are reflecting on that? Oh my god, there's no way. This is like a whole new game, and I'm not just saying that to joke around. This is literally like a whole new game. It looks so new. It looks so amazing. I can't believe my computer hasn't melted yet. Holy crap. Like, I mean, oh, I can't get over that. That is awesome. Anyways, yes, if you watched my Talking War Thunder episode where I was talking about 45 different units I'd like to see in War Thunder, the TBD-1 Devastator was on that list. And then it was literally like a day after I posted that Talking War Thunder video, they released the development blog post talking about the TBD. And here it is in War Thunder. Equipped with a single pilot-controlled 12.7mm M2 Browning machine gun with 500 rounds in the nose. Well, actually, where is it? Is it in the nose? Is it, like, right in the nose? Because that's not the gun, as far as I know. I believe that's just, like, a telescope. Is it the gun? No, that's not the gun. Or is it? It might be. I can't tell. No, that just looks like... I don't see where the... Oh, my God! And then I look at all the bombs under the freaking plane there. I didn't even see that at the first moment. It also comes equipped with a single 7.62mm Browning machine gun in the tail. Thing's not well defended. However, it comes equipped with 12 100-pound bombs... AN-M30 by default. What else can this thing carry? It can also carry a 2,216-pound torpedo of two different types, and it can carry, this one's actually pretty good for its tier, it can carry six 100-pound bombs and two 500-pound bombs. That one would be pretty good for its tier. And I guess I didn't look for armor on the other aircraft. I might go back and look. It's got some steel in there behind the cockpit and right here in the engine, basically. Oh, it's got three crew members. Okay, I didn't even realize it's got three crew members. It has a pilot. It's got two pilots. Okay, a very low-tier aircraft with two pilots. You usually don't see that kind of thing until you get to the B-25s and PBJs. And, of course, it's got a gunner. Let's take a look at the other aircraft here and see if we can spot any things with that. Let's preview this guy. Show armor. He's got some armor. Wow, he's actually got quite a bit. He's got some really light armor, steel for 6.5mm. And he's also got, just behind the cockpit, he's got 9.5mm of steel, and right here he's got bulletproof glass. Wow, you don't see that in many aircraft. Bulletproof glass, 38mm of it. Okay, that thing's going to be pretty hard to punch through the pilot, and it's only got a single pilot there. Let's check out, what about the P-38J? Does it follow the same formula? Yeah, it's got the same formula, all the same millimeters of armor. And it's still got the single pilot there, okay. What about the new P-38E? Preview. These follow the same formula? Yes, he follows the exact same formula and the same pilot. And as for the SB-2CU, he's also got a little bit of protection. What the hell? Look at this. The gun back here actually has a little bit of shielding on it. I didn't even realize. Wow, okay. Just behind the cockpit, got 11.11mm of steel. Oh, this thing has bulletproof glass as well. And... then we've got, like, this little lip down here. Steel, 8.5mm effective thickness. Wow. I like how they... see, a lot of people don't think there's actual armor ratings on aircraft, but there is. And that's it for the United States Aviation Tech Tree. that I can see. I'm still a little confused because I don't see the P-38K. See, originally we got a devlog post on the P-38E and the P-38K, and they said the P-38E was the standard unit and the P-38K would be a premium unit, but I don't see any new premium units here. So maybe they mean it's an exclusive P-38 that we'll have to get our hands on at some point. Don't worry, I won't miss out on the ground forces. I'm doing them last. The Germans, they get some new aircraft, which I am thoroughly excited for. What? Okay, well, I don't see any new aircraft just yet. Oh, yeah, I do. What the hell am I talking about? Okay, so here's their tech tree. I still don't have the freaking Tier 5 Arado 234. We'll get that at some point. There should be new fighters here. There should be new BF-109s. Yes, right here. There should be two new BF-109s. A BF-109E, two E's? I only see one E variation of the BF-109. Uh-oh. Oh, don't tell me they haven't added another one of the BF-109s. Why post a dev blog post about it and then not add it to the game? Okay, that's interesting. Well, the first new unit here on the list is the BF-109E4, which is in the E series, right here. Let's take a look at her. Right, she carries the basic German 220mm MGFFM cannons, which I believe are the low-velocity versions with 120 rounds, and also two 7.92mm machine guns in the nose, MG-17s with 2,000 rounds, 1,000 each. So it's the basic BF-109E variant, besides the E1, it's at Tier 2, required RP is 9,200, battle rating 2.7, and everything else about it seems pretty basic to BF-109E variants, but I'm still confused on where the E7, because we were supposed to have an E7 variation, but I don't see it in here, anywhere on this list. Any new, like, Italians that they decided to slip in? Doesn't look like it. Any new 190s? No. No new 190s. We have a new heavy fighter, I believe, the DO-17Z7, which is right here. Yep, it's a strike fighter as well. This is our very first strike fighter in the game, as far as I know. Oh, no. Heavy fighter and strike fighter. They've just now added this new strike fighter thing. I don't remember ever seeing that. Let's take a look at the DO-17Z7, which is a new low-tier attacker thing. Let's see. It's battle rating 1.7, tier 1, 4,000 RP required. It comes equipped with one 20mm MG-151 cannon and three 7.92mm MG-17 machine guns, plus two turrets, two single turrets, one on the top and I think one on the bottom? Yes, one pointing straight down, which are 7.92mm MG-15s. And it might just seem, it's pretty, you know, basic for a Tier 1 aircraft, but the Germans, they've always needed more Tier 1s. I guess they do actually have quite a few now. But that's a nice addition, especially for heavy fighters, seeing that they... Well, I was just about to say, seeing that they don't have many, and then they've got quite a few, actually. But that's not it for the Germans. The Germans also should get a new Tier 1 bomber right here, the DO-17Z2. The DO-17Z2 is a Tier 1, 1.7 battle rating, 4,000 RP required light bomber, I believe. It is equipped with one pilot-controlled MG-17 7.92mm. And it also has seven freaking machine guns. Holy hell! Look at this. It's got seven. It's got seven 7.92mm MG-15s. Sure, they're only 30 cals, but look at the turret. Look at the freaking. I almost said turret. Look at the cockpit area of this thing. Look, we've got a gun pointing out this way. Got two guns out that way. Two guns right out the side. Any on the bottom? Got one pointing straight down. Okay, this thing might be pretty well defended against things flying in from like the side of it. But it's a bomber, so you know. Let's tread lightly here until we see exactly how it works in game. I forgot to show armor on the other thing. Let's check the modifications. What can this thing carry? By default, it looks like it has nothing. It can carry 10 50-kilogram bombs, two 250-kilogram bombs, or four 250-kilogram bombs. That four 250-kilogram bombs is definitely going to be a good one. And for armor, it's got 8.5mm of steel throughout the entire thing. And it also... Oh, wow, look at this. It's actually only got... three gunners out of the seven guns. So one gunner actually like controls multiple guns. Okay, that's interesting. And let's check the BF-109E4 preview. Show armor. That's also got 10mm of steel behind and below the cockpit. So if something's on its ass, hopefully you won't be getting your pilot shot out. Again, no new premiums here. I'm a little Wait, I didn't check this plane. I'm a little confused on where this B-17, not B-17. There was supposed to be another BF-109E variant. Ooh, this one's got bulletproof glass. 60 millimeters of bulletproof glass. Holy tits, guys. Wow, okay. And then it's got some really thin steel throughout the rest of the plane. Okay, 60 millimeters. Crap. Okay, don't know when we're gonna, if we're gonna see that plane pop up anywhere. Because I don't see it in any of these BF-109 lists. It's not the BF-109B1. Wouldn't have it either. Anything new in here? Doesn't look like it. No new bombers, nothing there. What about here? No. Any SM-79s? No. Well, I guess that's it for the German aviation tech tree. A little confused on that. That's two planes that we were told were coming to the game, but don't seem to actually be here yet. The P-38K. And of course, yes, to be fair, we didn't know that the P-38J or L were coming. At least I didn't. They weren't on the dev blog. But I don't think that's an excuse to take away a German plane. We need more German planes. I think we need some more mid-tier and higher-tier German planes. That's my opinion. I mean, lately, it's just been... In the last few patches, they've just been getting constant tier 1s. And yes, I do understand that the only thing recently that they've gotten for their higher tiers is the BF-109G14. That's it for fighters. Everything else has been things like the BF-109E, the BF-109B1, and I remember, I think the patch before that, we got the F1 and F2. You know, these are good fighters. I like these, the F1 and F2, and the BF-109B1's pretty good. But I think we should get some more higher tier, like the K8 or whatever. No, the K14, I think, is what it was called. Something like that. I really want that BF-109. Anyways, moving on to the Soviet Union. The Soviets, they get a few new additions. I'm just quickly looking through to see if I see any. Hello? I don't see any. Oh, I do. Okay. Okay. So let's take a look here. For starters, there should be a new Yak. Yes, right here. The Yak 9B. 14,000 RP required. It is Tier 2, battle rating 3.3. The Yak 9B is that Yak we saw in the dev blog that was literally shitting out bombs. Let's see. It has a single 20mm Shavak cannon with 120 rounds and a single 12.7mm machine gun in the nose. Basic Yak armament. However, what's different about this thing is, does it have any armor? It does. Holy shit, it actually has bulletproof in the black and bulletproof in the front, plus steel there. This thing, as you can see, just behind the cockpit, you can see four little holes, and those are actually for bombs, and the bombs will actually be crapped out the bottom of the plane. Let's see here. It doesn't seem to... Well, actually, it looks like there are no bomb pylons, so I think you can either equip them with or without if you want, which is good, because some people will want to fly this as a fighter pier. Yet you can carry only 100 kilogram bombs, sadly, but you can either carry 2, 3, or 4. So that's nice. So you don't have to fly with bombs if you don't want to. All right, it's nice to have that player freedom there. Okay, so that's a new Yak. Is there anything else here on the list? Nothing new there. Nothing new in the MiG section. I-16s, no. Surprising, we didn't get any new I-16s. Any new legs? No. No new Lavochkins. No new SUs. Nothing P-38 or IL-2 related. But there is a new bomber. A new Tier 3 bomber, in fact. And here she is. The PE-8. 50,000 RP required. Tier 3. I'm just looking to see if there's anything here that I might have missed. Nope. And it is the PE-8. And how big is she? She's pretty big. Holy crap, she is really big. Look at that wingspan. Okay. So this is a new heavy bomber, correct? It doesn't seem to want to say. Yes, it is a new heavy bomber. Now, when I researched this thing, I saw that it had multiple freaking 20mm cannons. And it does. Holy shit, it actually does. Okay, let's take a look at exactly how this thing is armed. It actually has guns right there. Look at that. Okay. So one of my friends has actually been super excited for the PE-8, and I've actually seen... Because I never heard of the PE-8. I never heard of it. And apparently a lot of people... When I said that I've never heard of this thing, people started disliking the video because they were really excited for it, and they wanted it since, like, the IL-2 games. I apologize. I never heard of this freaking thing, okay? It's Russian. I don't hear about many Russian things. I'd really like the camouflage on this thing, but let's take a look exactly what else it has. 4.3 battle rating, tier 3, Does it have any armor on it for starters? It has armor, just a little bit of steel down there by the guns, and some steel up there in the cockpit area. All right, now let's take a look at how crazy this thing is armed with. It has two 20mm Shavak cannons. I don't know where they are, but I believe they are. I believe they are the. I'm not sure. I can't tell if that's a Shavak cannon on the tail section here and one on the top. Obviously, we've got a tail gunner and a top gunner. I'm not exactly sure what these are called, which is the only thing I know is waist gunners and tail gunners. I'm not really good with the other ones. There's also two 50 caliber machine guns with 400 rounds, and I think the 50 cals might be. Okay, it's either the 50 cals are the tail and top gunner, or they are the gunners right here under the actual, like, behind the landing gear. Or those are the 20 mils and the 50 cals are on top in the back. And there's also one dual 30 cal, which I think is the front machine gun. Good job. The Russians actually put the 30 cal up front where you're never going to need to use it. So it's going to be real interesting figuring out exactly. Oh, wait, what the hell am I doing? I just go to X-ray and hover over the gun. Oh, that just calls it the defensive armament. It doesn't actually tell you what size it is. Okay. It's got a crap ton of fuel tanks. It's got 3 fuel tanks per wing. This thing's going to burn. It is going to burn big time. 4 engines. We don't have many 4-engined aircraft in the game, so it's really nice to see that. Now, there is actually such a thing as a 6-engined aircraft, and I really want to see it in War Thunder at some point. I believe it was a Japanese plane. Or no, an 8-engined aircraft. There was 4 engines on each wing. Now, but it looks like by default it carries 40-50-kilogram bombs. I mean, look, this thing is the biggest Russian bomber in the game now. Look, it's bigger than the Year 2, which was previously the biggest bomber. That's the Year 2 over there in the hangar. Let's see, modifications. I think by default it carries that much. You can... Holy shit. Okay, you've got to be kidding me. This thing's, like, better than a fucking B-17 in what it can carry. 40 kilogram bombs, 40-50 kilogram bombs, 40-100 kilogram bombs, 12-250 kilogram bombs, 6-500 kilogram bombs, 4-1000 kilogram bombs, or a single 5000 kilogram bomb. Now the 5000 kilogram bomb is worth over 10,000 pounds. The B-17 can only carry 6,000 pounds of payload, at least the B-17E. This thing so far has the biggest payload. I seriously hope we don't get that old bombing thing in arcade. Remember when that whole thing was a craze when before Gaijin added the bombing points, when people were jumping in yours because they had unrealistic payloads, and in one match, in a matter of 3-4 minutes, two Year 2s would just drop a few bombs on the our airfield, bomb it, boom, done, match over. Remember that? Remember when crap like that wasn't fun? And then they added the bombing points and added more health to the airfields? I think we're going to have a little bit of confliction. Oh, look at the bombs. There's actually some hanging on the wings there on the pylons. That is really cool. Okay, so this thing's going to be absolutely terrifying to both fight and bomb with. But that is it for the Russians, I believe. Nothing here that we were promised that we didn't see, like with the other two nations. So I think, yeah, it's time to move on to the next nation, which is the British. Alright, the British have... They should have a new aircraft. Hello? Oh, it's a jet. Aha, right here. Oh, they've actually moved it. Okay, so the Vampire FB-5 and Venom FB-4, they used to be over here in the attacker tree. But they have been moved over to the... I believe this is the Hawker tree. Yes, because the Hawker Vampire, Hawker Venom, and Hawker Hunter. So the new aircraft in the game is by far probably the most, popular with people. Everybody has been going crazy for this thing to be added, and it is the Hawker Hunter F1 for 380,000 RP, which isn't surprising. Let's go ahead and preview this thing. Now, I'm going to be very careful what I say, because not only is this plane by far extremely beautiful, I have to say that. This plane is absolutely beautiful. It is by far my favorite looking jet in the game. But when I did the upcoming content War Thunder video on this, I neglected to mention the fact that a pilot had crashed a Hawker Hunter recently during the time I did that video, and people sadly were killed in that event. It was an air show, and I neglected to mention it and, like, give my respect to the families because I had never heard of it, and what I resulted in was a big flame war, not only in my comment section, but in my rating system, because people were flipping out that I didn't mention it and didn't pay my respects. I am so sorry I didn't ever hear of it. Holy crap, what a crime. So I'm going to be very careful what I say between this aircraft. It comes with four 30mm cannons. Wow. Was expecting 20mm cannons. This thing is armed to the teeth. 600 rounds between those cannons. This is going to be an amazing. It's 9.0 battle rating, tier 5. So it's not surprising there. Look at this. 688 miles per hour of default speed. I don't know exactly how fast the other one is. It's got 64 millimeters of bulletproof glass and 12.7 millimeters of steel. So this is definitely going to be an interesting aircraft. This might actually be a jet I try to fly for my first time. Because as you guys know, I'm not much of a fan of jets. And here's, of course, the Firebrand that I neglected to mention last patch. So I might as well show it now. Here's the Firebrand, 50,000 RP. I still don't have it. It's a very odd-looking aircraft, but apologize about not showing that. All right, and that's it for the British as far as I can tell, right? Let's just check to make sure here. Always doubly checky. No new Hurricanes, no new Spitfires, no new Seafires, no new Premiums. Excuse me. And let's check out the Japanese tech tree. All right, the Japanese, they only get, I believe, one new aircraft, I believe. Just going to double check here. Double checking all of the folders with units in them. Yes, they only get one new unit, and it is a Tier 3 premium unit. Right over here, the A7M1 NK9H, with a very odd camouflage that I personally don't like. However, this is an experimental aircraft, pretty much. Now, the A7M was one of the aircraft that was on my 45 units I'd like to see in War Thunder video I did. And that's two units so far that were added to the game right after I did that video. It's like I knew, but I didn't. But technically, I wanted the A7M, not the NK9H version. I believe the NK9H is the engine that this uses. Now, it's equipped with two 13.2mm Type 3 machine guns, which we have never seen in the game before. This is an entirely new model of machine gun. And two 20mm Type 92 cannons. The machine guns and cannons are in the wings, I believe. So they're both wing-mounted. It is a Tier 3 battle rating 3.3, so it's not ultra-deadly in terms of flight performance. Let me see here. It's got some bulletproof glass, 70 millimeters of thickness, and some 13 millimeter of steel. It's got a single pilot, of course. And I just want to check here. It is 2,190 Golden Eagles, which will set you back about $14. More of like $13, probably. What was I going to check? I was going to check something. Oh, yes. Let's check realistic battles here. 18 seconds. Okay, so it's pretty maneuverable, it seems. It's got an okay speed. In fact, the speed is actually greater than the A6M5, which is higher tier than it. Okay, yeah, this thing could be dangerous in realistic battles. What's the climb rate? 3,000? That's not a bad climb rate. I won't complain with that. Yeah, this thing could be dangerous in realistic battles. All right, I guess it's another moment that we've all been waiting for, and that's to take a look at the new ground forces in the game. So we'll start with the United States and work our way over. Click on Army. All right, the United States have been introduced the United States have not been introduced, but they have been introduced with new vehicles onto the list, of which we have quite a few. By quite a few, I mean not many. okay. So the first new addition on the list is a new Tier 5 light tank right here, the T-92. Now, the T-92 is a new Tier 5 light tank. We haven't had any previous Tier 5 light tanks. With 220,000 RP as a requirement, it is Tier 5, battle rating 6.7. Let's take a look at this. Okay. I can't change the camouflage condition. Apologize about that. So this thing comes equipped with a 76mm T185E1 cannon with 60 rounds. So it's only 76mm, but I'm apologizing. I'm assuming that it is actually going to have a nice high velocity and have some quite penetration. In fact, it probably has to, since it's at battle rating 6.7. But this thing, remember, this thing isn't really meant for head-on combat. It's going to be meant for flanking, moving fast. I mean, it's got a max speed of 35 miles per hour by default in realistic battles, which is actually, I think, about 10 millimeters or 25. Son of a bitch! It's about 10 miles per hour faster than the things like the M26. It also has two machine guns, a 30 cal and a 50 cal, which obviously you can see here, which are also, so basically this is technically a multi-turreted tank. We've got the machine guns here and there. That's the 30 cal and this is the 50 cal. So, I mean, it looks like a nifty tank. It's very unique looking, and it's the United States' first Tier 5 light tank. Let's take a look at the armor. I know the armor is probably going to be really, really thin. Yes, only 12.7 millimeters of armor at this kind of tier, and the effective thickness is only 24.9 millimeters. This thing is going to die every time. Now, the turret is, I mean, yeah, see, even though it's red, that's just red for what the rest of it is. Because even the red spots are only a maximum effective thickness of like 50 millimeters, if that. So this thing is not going to want to be hit. Things like machine guns are going to be able to penetrate this thing. That's just how thinly armored it is. So be careful out there on the battlefield with this. Use it like a flanking vehicle. Use its maneuverability to your advantage. In fact, I would like to test drive some of these vehicles. So we're going to test drive the T-92 here. I mean, I know I'm not test flying the planes. But the reason for that is it's longer to test fly the planes. Okay, so this is stock, remember, and we're already moving quite fast. Maneuverability here is quite good. I've got, I believe, I've got composite rigid ammunition loaded, which means that is default. So here are my machine guns firing. Now, yes, the machine guns will turn, as you can see. My 30 cal is actually aiming like that. The turret traverse speed seems to be a little low. I mean, it's not bad, but it's a little low. Remember, this thing will probably be a lot better once it's actually upgraded. Alright, now let's check to see the actual... Now, does it have good gun depression? All U.S. tanks do, and look at that. Look at that gun depression. How low will that go? That's as low as it'll go. Look at that. That's really nice. Okay, now let's actually put a shot into this Panther here. I'm going to... Oh boy, what is going on there? Did they change something with the thing? Because I'm not really zooming in much. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, look at that. I didn't even need to really range my gun. It penetrated, of course, composite rigid. Not much fragmentation. It's going to be hard to take this guy out. Because the shell's literally just going right through. Let's get a shot right in here. Knock out his driver. There you go. He's dead. Alright, now let's actually try and range on this Tiger tank back here. Elevation's a little slow, but it will probably be better once we upgrade it. And... yeah, the velocity on this gun is absolutely amazing. So, despite it being a 76mm gun, what really is strong about this is its maneuverability and the velocity on the gun. Because that is amazing. Alright, let's pop out of this and take a look at the next vehicle. For firing heavy armored targets, composite shells are recommended. I guess I should show... Let's go back into preview here. X-ray. It has four crew members, a driver, and a gunner, a loader, and a commander. Okay. The next vehicle on the list is a new Tier 4, the T-25, which is a new medium tank. At battle rating 6.0, Tier 4, 100,000 RP required. Let's take a look at this baby. I was excited for this. Alright, the T-25 is a... looks like a really stubby version of like the M26. It has a 90mm M3 gun, which is a very good gun. It has a mounted 50 cal and a 30 cal in the turret. Let's take a look at armor here. Armor is... not going to protect you in this thing. It has... five crew members, a machine gunner, a driver, a loader, and a gunner, and a commander. And let's take a test drive with this thing. We'll try her out, if you know what I mean. Okay. It's not the 90mm gun we get on... Now, they have changed the zooming in thing. They've edited that a little bit. It's not the 90mm gun like we get on vehicles like the M26E1, but I'm hoping that it's still a good vehicle altogether. Basic shell, but I just want to see what the velocity is like here. Man, that zooming in is really... Oh, it's like they changed it. Because before it used to zoom in a little further, and then the top and bottom of the reticle, or of the zoom in part, the gun sight view would be cut off, and I think they did that on purpose. Okay, ranged it pretty well. So the velocity on this is actually pretty good. And there's the guns firing off. It's always nice to have a 50 cal mounted, because it can pretty much aim anywhere you want it to, as you can see. So that it's really nice to have the 50 cal mounted. And a lot of U.S. vehicles, especially medium tanks, get that mounted 50 cal. So it's not a premium. It's a standard vehicle. Goes right through. All right. So that's the T-25, which is a nice addition to the United States tech tree. What else have we got here on this list? The United States also get a new premium vehicle, a Tier 4 premium, the M26 T-99, which is a new rocket vehicle. For 5,990 Golden Eagles, which will set you back, let's see here, maybe 30 bucks around that area. The M26 is basically literally an M26 variant, but better. No, it's not better. It's the same thing. It's literally just an M26 with rockets on it. It has a 90mm M3 gun, and it is equipped with 44 T-34E1 rockets and a 30 caliber machine gun in the turret, of course, as you can see there. Now, I want to see, is this the exact same thing as the M26? Yes, it is literally the exact same thing as the M26, but with rockets. Now, the previous thing, as you can see, the Calliope has moved on the list. This one has 60 T-34E1 rockets, which is probably why this one costs more. But let's test drive the M26E1, and we'll take a look at its armor after. So the T-25 has the same gun as the M26, only without the muzzle brake. Now, remember, guys, this doesn't just have to be a rocket vehicle. It is literally a premium M26. If you're a fan of the M26, just get this not for the rockets, but instead for the fact that it's a premium M26. So we got the same gun here. There you go. Well, that one was a nice kill. Okay. And control should fire my rockets. Let's see here. Uh-oh. How do you fire rockets? R? What the hell? It changed my key bindings. My key binding was always control to fire rockets. Controls. Tank control. Fire main. Fire special gun is 4 or mouse button 5, whatever the fuck that is. 4. Okay. Okay, yeah, same. It's still got a lot of drop. Okay, it's going to fire off the right amount of rockets first. And then, what? Okay, I see. It fires off the bottom row, and then switches to the left side. And then I missed. There we go. Okay, that was a one-hit kill on a Panzer. And it's going to fire off my next one, and then it'll start firing the right one. Yes, okay. Very nice, and I do not believe you will reload your rockets in the battle unless you go. I think it's unless you go back to a point or an arcade. I'm not exactly sure, but yes, literally a premium M26 with rockets. So remember, you don't need to have it just for the rockets. If you have enough money to throw over and you're a big fan of the M26, and you don't want to buy the M26E1, just buy this thing because it's a premium M26. Everything about this is probably the same thing. It's armor, everything else. Let's take a look. M26 isn't well armored anyways, really. Let's see. Modifications. No, wait. What are you doing? Let's see. Preview. The preview for this thing is... Yes, literally pretty much the same thing. The armor won't protect you in this. But M26, as I said, if you're a fan of it, same amount of crew members, everything about it. Now, if you guys know, I have been doing, like, ultra grinding, trying to fully grind out my tech trees. I fully ground out the Russians and Germans owned every vehicle. Of course, they've got new vehicles now. And the United States, I didn't get close. The only thing I got was the M46. And the T95, I got pretty much halfway on that. T95. So, of course, the United States got some new vehicles I'm going to need to grind out. But the Germans and Russians, I had already owned all their vehicles. So now they've got some new stuff, so I got to flip back to their nations and start driving things like the Panther 2 again and the IS-2 Revenge to grind out what vehicles they've got. So let's check the German tech tree, shall we? The Germans, I think they only get... They get two new vehicles, I believe? Yes, they only get two new vehicles. And the first one is a new Tier 2 Premium. Oh, here it is. Okay, let's not sperm all over the place yet. I've already done that a few times already. This is the Panzerwerf 42, which is a German half-track, which is the first drivable German half-track in the game with rockets. Yes, it's another new rocket vehicle. Each of the nations, at least the Germans, Russians, and Soviets, they all get a new premium rocket vehicle. This is equipped with 10 NBWF-41 rockets and a single 30 caliber machine gun. Definitely, definitely not meant to be in combat. That is for sure. Not direct combat. Although I know I'm going to come in direct combat with this thing. I mean, look at this. It's got a whole 8 millimeters of thickness of armor on it. This thing is not going to protect you. Now, when I said first German half-track in the game, I meant to say the first armored German half-track. This, not the SDKFZ, not the flak track like we've got now. There's no point in really trying to drive this thing. It's basically just got a direct fire turret on it, similar to the M26. Or the M26 with the rockets on it, but without the actual main gun. The only thing it's got to protect itself is an MG34. Or no, that's an MG42. Oh, shit. I thought it was an MG34. No, that's an MG42. Well, there you go, guys. I know a lot of people are going to enjoy this. It is 4,800 golden eagles, which, again, will set you back about $30. So I definitely really want my hands on that vehicle at some point. But the other vehicle that the Germans get is a new Tier 5. Lovely. I love grinding out Tier 5s. Whew. It is a new Tier 5 tank destroyer, the Jagdpanzer 4-5, or that thing. For 380,000 RP, coming in after the Jag Tiger, let's take a look at her. The Jagdpanzer 4-5 has the tiniest-ass gun I've ever seen and looks very Russian. And look at this, it's also got all of its little smoke things back here, but obviously Gaijin won't let you use those yet. It does have an MG3A1 30 cal, which looks like a modification of the MG42, and it has a 90mm BK90 gun with 51 rounds. 7.7 battle rating, I'm a little confused. Now, Gaijin did say that this thing, I mean, it's not well armored as far as I know. No, the armor will not protect you in this thing either. I think what's really... up with this vehicle is its maneuverability, as far as I know. Now, of course, it is stock for me, but we can check it out. Its default shell is 271 millimeters at front or at point blank range, and it can unlock this disgusting post-war ammunition as well to fight World War II tanks with, which has the same amount of penetration at all ranges. So let's go ahead and actually just try it and see what the maneuverability is like. Alright, here we are. Oh, it's actually got two machine guns. It's got one in the freaking gun there, too. Excuse me. So the MG42 on the top actually cannot maneuver all the way back. Oh, yes. I love that sound. It is so good. There's like only one other tank in the game that has a... Holy shit! I'm stuck, and look at how fast I'm already moving. That acceleration, though. Okay, so we're on the move. We've got a 90mm gun. Wow. Look at this. and the gun reloads so fast. Look at that reload. Okay, so where the tank fails in armor, or where the tank destroyer fails in armor, it makes up in speed, maneuverability, and the gun. Holy crap. Imagine this thing armed with the post-war ammunition with this kind of fire rate at point-blank ranges. Anything is screwed if this gets the first shot off. Let's check the... This is realistic battles, and we have really good maneuverability. Look at this. How fast it turns. Oh yeah, this is going to be an awesome vehicle to drive. I want this thing. Let's see how well the gun actually aims in. KV-2 there. I shot right over it. Good velocity, very good reload time, very good maneuverability. This is going to be a great vehicle, in my opinion at least. If used properly.
Why are you doing this to me?
Alright. Oh, I just noticed at the top of the screen there seems to be a new... Oh, that's invites. Okay. Alright. The armor, yes, we looked at that. It's got 4 crew members. And that's it. And that's it for the Germans. Now, how about the Russians? They've got some new vehicles as well. Some pretty exciting additions. Here are the Russians. They've got 1 new standard unit, which isn't going to be too hard to grind out. They've also got a new Tier 1 premium, which is, yes, of course, the Russian rocket vehicle, which is the BM-84. The BM-84 is no need to test drive it, but is literally a really ugly tank. It comes equipped with 24 M-8 rockets, which basically looks like the frickin' Katusha thing. Can fire directly, 2.3 battle rating, premium, of course, rewards and stuff. Armor, non-existent on this thing because of how low tier it is. Has 2 crew members, literally 2 crew members. The driver and, who the hell is this guy? The commander. Okay. And is 3,850 Golden Eagles, which is about $20, I'd say. Around there. But they have a new standard vehicle, which is very exciting. A very exciting addition. Just making sure I'm not missing anything here. No, it doesn't seem like it. This new exciting addition is, of course, the PT-76 light tank. A new Tier 4 light tank. 89,000 RP required. 5.7 battle rating. And, wow. Okay, so this is going to be a really fun vehicle to drive. Now, this is actually, historically, an amphibious tank, which means it can drive in water. However, before you get your testicles twisted in a knot, right off the bat in this patch, this will not be drivable in water, but Gaijin have confirmed that they will allow it to be driven in water in the future. It does have a machine gun that I didn't look at the size, but it sounds pretty hefty. Unless that's a new 30 cal machine gun sound, because that's not the normal sound for the 30 cal. And it comes equipped with... Sounds like an 85. I can't exactly tell. I totally neglected to mention. Now it is stock, but it doesn't seem to be very fast or maneuverable just yet. Now, actually, the maneuverability is pretty good. It feels like I'm driving a Panther tank. That's what it feels like to me. It might not seem like it on screen, but once you actually get driving it, it really does feel like that. But this thing will really shine once it can drive in water. Armed with composite rigid. Let's take a look at the details of this vehicle. Alright, let's check out the armor here. Now, the armor is pretty thin, 10 millimeters of armor. And what I love about how Gaijin say, oh yeah, but the sloping is what'll really do it. No, that is not with this big weak spot right here. 10 millimeters of armor, and people are going to be able to penetrate straight through that. This thing is going to die. That is for sure. It is just a light tank, though. But like I said, despite, and it's only got 3 crew members, and that is weird how they're holding their ammo in there. Look at that. But like I said, despite everything about it, it has a 76mm D56TS. It sounds like an 85. Like I said, okay, and it only comes with a 30 cal. They must have changed the sound, maybe. Okay, anyways, like I said, despite everything, the stats of the vehicle, the gun, the maneuverability, the armor, everything about it, what will really make this thing unique is when it is able to travel through water, because you'll be able to flank enemies in a new way and hide from enemies in the ocean. In the ocean. I don't know why I said it like that. But that's not it. There's still one nation where we haven't looked at yet. And that would be the British. The British have a new ground forces tech tree, I believe. I don't think there's much there. I haven't looked at it yet. No, there is not much there. Holy crap, it looks like when we were closed beta testing it. Okay, so it's time to do a little explaining. Yes, as you can see, the British ground forces, which were supposed to be added in this update, they're doing it like they did with United States ground forces. They didn't actually add in the full tech trees just yet. Basically, they will be closed beta testing it. And if you purchase the packs, you can get a chance to enter. I'm not really going to be doing that. I will be purchasing the packs because, as far as I know, they're not limited time. But I will be purchasing the packs at some point in the future. But I'm probably not going to worry about getting into the closed beta testing for British Ground Forces. I'll wait until they're added to the game fully, and then I'll start grinding out their tech trees. But as you know, there are 4 different vehicles to choose from. One for a premium vehicle for each tier. They are bundled units, so you have to buy them off the Gaijin store online. And we have the Tier 1 version, which is a battle rating 1.7, the Mark IV A13 Mark II tank. So we can take a preview at this thing. Armed with a 40mm QF 2-pounder cannon and a 7.7 Vickers machine gun, it is the first, or second, it's the first real British tank in the game, but the second British tank technically, since the Grant 1 is technically a British modification of the M3 Lee. So we're going to go ahead and check the armor here. Tier 1, 1.7. Armor is basic for that tier. Pretty thin. On the inside, we've got 4 crew members. We can go ahead and test drive this. Realistic battles, just to give it a try. Here it is. It's got a slow turret traverse. But with it being a light tank or a medium tank or whatever, I don't actually remember what it is. I totally just forgot. It moves really fast, which is to be expected from this tier. What the hell? Is that a freaking gas mask? Do you see that? Look on the back of the turret. Is that a gas mask? That is creepy as shit. So let's check out this gun here. Now, does it have a new sound? Ooh! It has a new sound. Oh, I love new gun sounds. Oh, it sounds so powerful. Okay, let's shoot at some enemy tanks. Let's see how well the... Okay, it's not bad. And it is penetrating straight through the side of a Panther. No problem there. Oh, I love that new sound. That's a great new machine gun sound. Okay, this thing's going to be fun to drive. Now, the turn speed's a little stiff off the start. Alright, let's check out the next vehicle. Hey, that's a new loading screen. These pictures are all not new, but they're new to the loading screens as far as I'm concerned. The next one here, now I have no idea how much these cost. You'd have to check the main site. The next one is this, which is the 17-pounder M10 65th Anti-Tank Regiment. It is a modification of the United States M10 tank destroyer, armed with a 76.2mm QF 17-pounder cannon, one of the most famous guns in the world, 12.7mm mounted machine gun. It is literally an M10, no need to drive it. The only thing different here is the fact that it looks like it's got more detail added to it, more antennas, and it's also got a 76.2mm gun. Same exact amount of armor as far as I can tell. And it's got 5 crew members. The next one, however, is a very special edition. This is the Firefly Scorpion, which is the Sherman 1C 2nd Warsaw Armored Division. Now, this is literally the Sherman Firefly, another vehicle that people have wanted in War Thunder for a long time. It is a British modification of the M4 Sherman. Let's see here. Basic Shermany armor. Might have a little more. I can't exactly tell. However, what shines on this thing is the gun, as far as I know. 5.0, Tier 3, has a, like I said, 76.2. We're going to test drive this thing. This has the 17-pounder gun, the famous one. That is also a new one. Holy hell, look at that. ME-410 crashed into the ground. There's a propeller flying by. What tank is that? I couldn't tell what tank that was. Okay, turret traverse seems good. It's got a mounted 50 cal and a 30 or 50 cal in the turret. Can't tell. It moves like a Sherman, feels like a Sherman in realistic battles. Now, the 17-pounder is supposed to be amazing. First of all, it doesn't have a new gun sound. Time to change my pants a second time. Okay, let's try this thing out on that Panther way over there. It's dead. Okay, I'm getting this thing. I don't care what I say. I'm going to get this thing because this is going to be amazing. I can kill this guy with my 50 cal. He says as he proceeds not to kill it. There you go, it's dead. And then I miss. Yeah, this thing's going to be awesome, guys. I know a lot of people are going to be driving this. Now, yes, it is a premium bundle Sherman Firefly, but do not worry, Gaijin. I believe have gone on record for saying that there will also be a standard Sherman Firefly. This is just a premium version of it, hence the special Warsaw Armored Division with the Scorpion on the side. Return back, and there's one more vehicle to look at, which I'm super excited for. Dun, 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 dun! All right. The Tier 4 version is the Black Prince. I am ultra excited, guys. Here it is. I believe a future modification of the Churchill tank, which is one of my favorite tanks of all time because of it looks so pretty. I love its looks. Now it comes with a 76.2mm QF 17-pounder cannon and a 30 cal, of course. So it comes with the same cannon as the previous tank, but it's also a heavy tank. Let's take a look at the armor here. I don't see the armor protecting this thing too much, but it will probably bounce a few shots, especially if you diamond angle that about like that, maybe. It might bounce a few shots here and there. Other than that, I don't see this thing being too well armored. However, how much crew member does it has? It only has 5. How much crew member does it has? Let's test drive this baby. Only 6.7 battle rating. That's, or I'm sorry, 6.0. That's really good, not 6.7. So of course everybody was bitching at me. Well, not everybody. Only really one or two people.
It's so slow. It is so slow. Oh my god. I don't like slow tanks. This thing is shit. It's so slow.
There's that really badass sounding machine gun, and Panther, you are about to die. Yeah, I'm getting this thing. I'll see. It won't be any. It probably won't be within the next few, the next week or couple weeks that I won't be able to pick up, or that I'll be able to pick up one of these vehicles. But I'm gonna try at least getting this thing. If I can't get this, I'll get the Sherman Firefly. And if I can squeeze out a few more dollars, I might be able to get both. We'll see. I want all of them at some point, of course, but I at least want the Black Prince because this thing seems so awesome to me. Yeah, this is going to be awesome. Now, the turning here is a little poopy. Other than that, everything else seems pretty fine. Then again, a lot of tanks are like this. I'm not going to be able to do anything to that. Nah, okay. All right, that is the Black Prince. So remember, if you want early access or a chance to get early access, purchase one of these packs or all of them, whichever you feel, or just purchase them so that you're ready for when the British Ground Force tech tree is actually fully added. I'm sure it won't be too long. I'm sure we don't have to wait another 16,000 months. Because when they did this with the US, they did the same thing. They had, like, Tier 1 was available for everybody, and if you purchase one of the packs, you get access to all tiers. And then they released it fully to everybody not too long after. And that should be everything for new vehicles. Now let's see. All in, yeah, so you can easily pop up that. Play with friends, that simple tutorial, tank part 2. There's another tank tutorial? Tank gunnery. Yeah, there's another tutorial, it seems. Let's actually check that out. I'm not going to play it or anything. I just want to see if there's... Yeah, there is a new... The other one was tank control basics, and now we've got tank gunnery. Okay. I'll have to check that one out then. There is also should be a new... Let's see, there should be a new crew system. Yes, there is a new crew system. What the hell is this? Oh god. I don't understand what this is. Crew level. Here's keen vision. So what it does differently now is it'll actually tell you what is changing. So like if I go to tank driving, like let me go to gunner here maybe. No, let me go to loader speed, which is should be maxed out completely, almost. Yeah, see, it's affected by things like leadership, the primary reload time. Oh, I see, it shows you. See, right now, I think my reload time normally with this is 11.92 seconds, but now it's 11.1 seconds. Or no, the base is 14.43. I'm really confused. And if you get the bronze star, it subtracts it. If you get the silver star, which is over here, it subtracts it. And if you the leadership bonus also affects it, and this is ace. If I upgrade that, it'll subtract it even more. Okay, so I still need to get used to it. I don't fully understand it yet, but at least the big change here is it now tells you what is different, and also there is agility now, which is the new skill that has been added. Yeah, invites. I don't have any invites. Okay, one other thing I wanted to check is I actually wanted to check the new water system. So we are going to go ahead and pop into custom battles, and we're going to load up ourselves a custom battle. Let's not go to Kursk. Let's go to, jungle. Jungle would be a good thing to test it on. That's a tournament, though. Let's not go to a tournament. Honolulu. I'm looking for ground forces, please. Ground strike, no. I'm looking for ground forces. Domination. Majdak. Oh, yeah, we should check out... No, these are all aviation. We should check out the new maps. Tank battles, you dumb shit. Poland, Kursk... Normandy, Berlin... Where the hell is the jungle? Oh, I totally passed it. Yeah, advance to the Rhine, or the crossing of the Rhine, is one of the new maps, along with Stalingrad. So we'll check those out. But let's first check... Oh, yeah, let's check out the destructible ability. We can do that in advance to the Rhine. Let's check out jungle to check out some of the new... Actually, I just realized I should make sure I've got a lineup here that's prepared for this. Yeah, the Germans should be good. Excuse me. Custom battles... Create a session. Go down here. We're going to go to the jungle. Start. Domination. Arcade. Yeah, we can keep it arcade. Day. Clear weather. Fuel and ammo is unlimited. Time limit. We'll go 15 minutes. Mission rotation. Include bots. Yes. Bots on tanks. Yes. Number of players 32. Password is going to be Pernus. Join in progress, no, any country, apply. Hopefully it doesn't end right away, because it likes to do that. Ready, start, domination jungle. Battle is already in progress. I just want to check out some of the new water rendering. I'm really excited. Doo-doo! So previously... I guess I shouldn't talk in the loading screens. Previously, the water... I can already see a little bit of it. Previously, the water was flat and basic. There wasn't any form of wave or motion to it. It was all flat and basic and pooey. Oh, look! You can actually see the boundaries of the map now. That's kind of neat. So now you know where you can and can't go. Oh, look at that. Look at right there. All right, here we are. We're in. The game looks absolutely amazing. We're going to flip on over here. Hello? Oh my god, look, the bots actually spawn in now? That's new. with names and stuff. Now, will they actually just drive around and fight each other? Because that'd be pretty cool. All right, guys, here we are, the new water render. Oh, look at return to the battlefield. Screw you. What? Assholes. I can drive right through that. Wait a minute. Don't tell me I can't drive over here. Because that would be poohy. Now, one thing I noticed is, see how that right out there, that corner where that rock is not out of boundaries? People in the PT-76, when it becomes amphibious, can drive over there and hide behind that rock and wait for the enemies to pass by and shoot them in the side. Now, look at this water. Now, if you want to see a full side-by-side comparison between this water and what it previously used to look like, you can look in on the main website or check out my upcoming content video. Look at how it actually moves across the sand now, which it never used to do. The enemy team is capturing Zone B. There should also be new effects in the water when you drive through it. Also, the water affects your units. So you can sit on the water with, say, a float or boat plane, and it will actually rock your boat plane back and forth. So let's go over and drive through some water. I'm not going to drive through that because that's pretty deep. Remember, that is ocean. That is Pacific Ocean. You want to drive through non-Pacific Ocean. Oh, we've got enemies fighting each other over here. Now, this water here seems to be a different color, does it not? Or is that just the lighting? That could just be the... Oh, I think that's just the lighting. I thought it looked like dirty water. All right, now driving through the water... Yeah, see, here's the new river effect. So, of course, it doesn't look like the ocean, of course, because it's not ocean waves. It's actual, like, river. Now, driving through it should cause an effect. Yes, look at that. It's pushing the water. Look at behind me. That was never there before. Look at this. That is awesome. Wow, he didn't die. Alright, that's a really nice effect. Look at how the water's like hitting my vehicle here and actually being affected by it. And this is all the NVIDIA GameWorks in work here. So you can see just how absolutely beautiful this is. I'm going to drive over and check the ocean one more time. Oh god, he's actually catching that guy on fire. Put yourself out, mate. Yeah, here's the ocean again, so you can see the waves are forming up again. I love that color of water. I'm getting shot at. Balls to you guys. Wish you could. Maybe you can change what kind of bots they are so they can be in heavier tanks and actually form a challenge. Whoa, look at these waves. These waves are really pushing up, aren't they? We didn't see that over there at the spawn. Oh, look at that as it comes up onto the beach. This kind of thing never happened before. Now, does it actually affect me, my performance, as I'm, say, I'm driving down the beach and the water comes pushing up? Will it actually affect me? Yes, it does. It does affect me. Wow, okay. Look at this, guys. This is amazing. It's such a different change. The graphics have been so changed. Wow. I am blown away. This is absolutely spectacular. I'd like to take a screenshot of this. Wait, actually, I like that one where it came up onto the beach. I know I'm taking screenshots live. There we go. Just taking some screenshots for maybe a thumbnail or two here and there. Here's got this asshole in his T-26. So they are spawning back in. That's really neat. Okay, they never had this system integrated before. So this must be something new. All right, let's take a look at destructible environment along with... Whoa, what is this? What? Did you see that? It had, like, new statistics. It was saying, like, what place in team I was, and I think it had, like, how many kills I had. Wow, okay, that's a nice change. So it's... Wow, okay. Let's go ahead and change the mission here. We're going to change it to the Stalingrad map. We'll change it to advance to Rhein first. No. Let's check Stalingrad out first. Check out Stalingrad. We'll start. Yep, everything is the same here. Ready and go. So there is destructible environment on this map as well. Da-da-da! Da-da-da-da-da! Okay, so this is the domination mode. We got A to the north, B in the middle, and C to the south. Basic stuff. We're going to jump into our leopard again. I hope that this thing can take down buildings. If it can't, I can just jump out and jump into my mouse or Yag Tiger. So this is not Stalingrad. This is Stalingrad Factory. So, sadly, I wanted the city, but this is better than nothing, right? So, let's see. Can we... Did it actually blow a hole in it? No, it didn't. Can I blow a hole in any of this stuff? No, it doesn't look like I can. I might need my mouse out for this. Well, I'll get my mouse out and check out some of the destruction, but first, let's actually check out the actual map here. So it looks like I'm heading north towards A right now. So there seems to be a lot of cover here. Oh, shit, son. Bombs and stuff. Yeah, look at this. These are all the factories, what's left of them. Can I blow out the windows? Oh, I can. You can blow out the windows. Although, it's just the frames, but obviously all the explosions are making it pretty spoopy. So we can see, yeah, we got main roads here. So this is going to be great. And see how there's all these holes in the building? Maybe you can't destroy these, but you can destroy those. I don't know. I don't think my gun's built to destroy that stuff. Yeah, okay. I can see myself liking this map. Now, this is the second wintry, snowy map. This is, the other one is Finland, so this is our second one. Can't wait for some British integrated, desert maps. So we've hit a roadblock here. It looks like we'll have to turn off before wow, we've been driving for quite a while. Map's pretty big, but at least it's not open, really. It's got a lot of stuff. So it looks like small tanks can actually go inside the factories. Now, can we, blow out the roofs here? You can. Look at that. I made the whole roof collapse in. That's awesome. We can drive out here. What about this? Yep, we can destroy that. That is awesome. Got walls over there. I'm assuming that that's the edge of the map. And actually, no, wait. Where is A at? A is inside this building. So here are the enemy tanks.
On target.
Yeah, right in here. So here's the first point. Look how people will be hiding behind these walls and you can blow them out. This is going to be an awesome new game thing. There's a new capture thing there. It actually shows up right on the screen. It never used to do that. It used to only say at the top of the screen. I'm not actually going to capture the zone. So let's head this direction and head towards B. It looks like most of the fighting is going on at B. I don't care if these guys shoot at me. They aren't going to do anything to me, I'd assume. Oh god, that actually scared me. The loader has been wounded. He actually penetrated me. What? Holy crap, okay. So here we have some of the train yards. Looking around here. I'm assuming that these cars are actually destructible. And then I miss it completely, entirely. The other ones in the other maps are destructible, but maybe not these ones. Yeah, look at my loader, damn it. I want to see if these are destructible. Okay, it doesn't seem I can destroy that, at least not with this gun. So it seems like mostly... What? I actually was killed by one of them. No way. Bots never used to kill you. Did they change the bots? Well, at least we can drive our mouse now. But it's going to be really slow. I mean, I am in arcade, but it's still going to be really slow. All right, let's go the other way now. Now can I destroy buildings? Let's see. Didn't do anything to it. Unless I was lied to about the destructible environment on this map. They said Stalingrad Factory and advance to the Rhein. Now I doubt the the guys are going to be able to penetrate through me. At least now. No, it doesn't seem like I can destroy anything. Maybe it's not entirely working for this map yet, and I was lied to. So B point seems to... So A point is up here in the actual factory parts. Seems B point is on the actual train tracks in the middle of the map, and C looks to be at more of an open part. In fact, it looks like I shouldn't have picked this vehicle to drive because it's really slow and big. It looks like this part of the map is all rubble. How is a mouse going to go about doing this? Over here, maybe? This is a long-ass video. Hold on, I'm going to jump out. I'm going to get in a faster vehicle here. Yeah, right here, score is 2. Wow. Oh, it tells you your lifetime as well. I survived for a whole 1 minute. Yag Tiger isn't that fast. Everything else I'm going to get killed in. Well, I'll try it anyways. I want to check out C. So it looks like the AI is actually going to prove to be some sort of threat now. The AI was never a threat really before. Even the big guns wouldn't be penetrating you. Now sometimes you'd rarely get killed, but look, the AI is actually fighting each other, going against each other's throats. Like, this is actually pretty neat. If you can edit what kind of vehicles they drive, I'm sure it would be more exciting to actually drive AI battles. This is better for people who want to learn how to play the game more on their own or with a friend, because the AI can actually prove to be a small challenge now instead of just sitting around at various points on the map. Maybe if the AI is more smart in actual battles, it'll be the same way too. So here we got the train tracks. Over there is C. So it looks like, yeah, like I said, it looks like this part of the map is a little more open than usual. Well, I say than usual, but... Okay, we got a wall here. Looks like there's actually water on this map, of course. We're on the... We're in Stalingrad. Part of it, at least. Get out of here. So far, I'm really liking the look of this map. It's a lot more exciting than I thought it was going to be. So, I mean, I still really want a Stalingrad, like, city map. But this one doesn't seem too bad. Wow, that was a miss. Alright, so C looks to take place here around these, like, oil things. Maybe I can't exactly tell what this is. Now, is the river frozen here? Can I bash through this? Yes, I can. Just a chain link fence. Felipe! Get out of here. Alright, so here we are at C. We have almost literally lost. We have lost. Holy crap, they obviously capped the zones. I wanted to look at the river to see if it's frozen or not. But we got a nice look at this map either way. Let's check out Across the Rhine. And let's see if that map... how that map looks. And, let's go to change the mission. Advance to the Rhine. I keep saying Across the Rhine. That's what they called it originally. So this is also Domination. Yes. Apply. Ready. Start. Alright, so this looks good. So, okay, oh, look at these. This is some strange... We got B, A is in the middle, C and B here. It looks kind of like B is closer to their side. We're going to spawn here. I can see this becoming one of my top maps because I love fully urban maps. And I remember when somebody told me, and so far everything they've said is completely wrong so far. Somebody told me that the Gaijin would never do full-on maps. Oh, come on. I don't think my gun is built for that. Damn. Full-on urban maps. And so far, this is the second one. The first one was... Look, at the AI are actually backing up for each other. The first one was... I say as that one drives completely through that. Anyways, the first one was Berlin. Oh, look at this. This looks awesome. Berlin doesn't look like this. So I'm now heading to... Oh. I'm going to turn around and head back towards C. And see if I can... discover what the tactics of this map are. Hostile team is already capturing zone A. So here we've got this big building here. I'm not exactly sure what that is. Some sort of church? Something? C is down that way. See, I'm trying to find the good flanking routes, because I really like to flank in a lot of my matches, a lot of my different types of tanks. See, I mean, this looks good, but it looks like, oh, enemies could totally pop out there. Here we got where the little trams would be driving. I can't seem to destroy anything. I mean, it could be my ammunition, too. Maybe I need high explosive. Yeah, I guess I didn't realize. Yeah, so these... I'm right on the edge of the map. In fact, I'm off the side of the map, and now I'm on the map. Here is C. Right in front of me. Looks like it's at this intersection here. We're fighting U.S. Right here. And down this road should be the other cap zone. I've got to be a little more careful since it seems that these guys can actually kill me. There goes an M2A4 there. At least it doesn't seem like the AI are bullshitty anymore either, because they used to always know exactly where you are and always shoot you and know where you are. But looks like it's not the case anymore. I'm heading towards B. I'm almost at B. So B is just down the main road. And then I'm going to take a hard right. Looks like both our spawn points and their spawn points are similar to each other, where you start in, like, the rubble. Yeah, here is this one. I just got shot at. They missed. Holy shit, what was happening there? Did you see that? What was that? Whoa, how did one of my teammates get over here? Please die. Shit, they actually penetrated, man. It's like they know. Save me, teammates. Save me. Okay, so just down here and to my right should be the A zone. Ground unit destroyed. See, there's C, and then we've got... Oh, God. Okay. That has never happened before. Oh, I totally passed the A zone. What am I doing? Please die. No! No, he's turning his turret with me. He'll shoot me in the side. Put your fire out, asshole. Don't hit that. I missed it again. What is wrong with me? Oh, it's right here. Holy crap, look at the size of this cap zone. Okay. It's right here. Alright. So this map seems to be giving me a lot of frame rate. It could just be Bandicam. I'm not exactly sure. But, wow. Okay, I could really come to like this map and the Stalingrad Winter map. So we are going to jump out, and I'm going to jump into... Apparently I captured a zone, even though I didn't. My engine compartment opens up. Okay, let's actually load our gun with high explosive. We're going to load the small gun with high explosive, too. And let's see if we can destroy buildings with this. If we can't, then we go to Berlin, because that, I do know, is supposed to have destructible environment. Okay, high explosive. Let's see if there's a difference here. Hello? It's not doing anything. I've been lied to. My whole life is a lie. What about me? Look at this. These buildings here. These buildings should, like, explode, right? Where's that guy going? Yeah, okay, the buildings are not exploding. Let's check Berlin. And if Berlin does have destructible environment, then I've been lied to. I'm talking about the main video, too, the actual release video. They said, oh, destructible environment will be available on three maps, including across, or including the advance to the Rhine, Stalingrad factory in Berlin. So let's check Berlin. And then I'm going to call it there. Do-do-do-do. Berlin, start, apply, ready, start. Brandenburg. No, I want to spawn up there, damn it. Okay, spawning in with... Actually, wait. I'm going to load a few of each here, just to test with both. Yes. Balls to it. Put me in the match, damn it. Alright, let's see here. How about on this map? I want to get a little closer to examine it if it's true. Whoa, I blew a piece off. This is with my little gun. Okay, so I'm blowing chunks off the top of it. But see, if it's like if I shoot the bottom here, it doesn't do anything. Does it? Let me try again. Shoot in the middle. Yeah, see, I shoot it there with my big gun. It doesn't actually topple it down. Now look, that's still collapsing over there. Do I have to just keep shooting it? Will it collapse at some point? Wait, I heard a crunch. Oh, look! What's gonna happen? Is it gonna topple over? Oh, can I bash right through it? Oh no, it's gonna topple over! It won't let me go through it. Okay, so I think I made a mistake. I think you can topple them over. You've just got to do enough damage, basically, until they crumble to pieces. And if you shoot the top, you'll just blow single pieces off anyways. Yeah, okay, so I was doing it wrong. So maybe it was available in the last match. I just wasn't doing it properly. See, look, and now that I've destroyed it enough, it's going to sit there and crumble to pieces. Okay, that's pretty cool. That's going to add more life to the matches. Lol, I hit your track. Okay. I'm gonna return to the hangar. That's pretty neat. And those there, guys, are all of the... Fuck off! Are all of the major additions to War Thunder 1.53. I'm very excited for this patch. I'm going to update my drivers now, as it seems maybe I'm having a little bit of spoopy time, at least with Advance to the Rhine. It's possible that map isn't optimized properly yet, but I am going to be sitting back and getting myself a lot of these Steam achievements all day today. So enjoy patch 1.53, guys, and I will see you in the next War Thunder video. Thanks for watching.